Things have been absolutely crazy over this past year. All of you have lived it. We all saw how the seniors graduated last year. I'm confident in saying that I wasn't the only one thinking then that it would pass and the class of 2021 would end up having a normal senior year and a normal graduation. This gradually became our new reality. COVID put a damper on the senior class of 2020, and it almost did the same thing to us, but we did it. I'm sure some of us, I know it's cliche, but I'm sure some of us never thought we'd make it. We survived all 4 years of high school, through failing multiple English tests and turning in our math notebooks late and less than completed almost every week, we all managed to pass our classes. I wouldn't have known that we did it without seeing everyone up here today. I'll start with Jackson. You haven't been here very long, but you're definitely quick to answer anyone with a witty comment. I haven't had much senior bonding time as we've only had two classes together this year. However, I'm glad you chose to graduate with our little group here in Skagway. Jackson is planning on working in customer service, building his way up the career ladder in that line of work. He plans to go to college a few years in the future. Ash has been here since freshman year. They have always been independent. They are very outspoken and brave. Ash is artistic and very musically inclined. At a talent show 1 year, Ash sang. They are planning to work in Skagway to earn money with the goal of moving out of Alaska. Ash enjoys working in retail and hopes to further their career learning more about the business. Okay, now I've known Aritha since I walked into preschool. She's one of the strongest people I know. She moved towns and schools her senior year, and I know if I attempted that, I may not have graduated. Aritha plans on moving to Juneau to work and save up her money to allow her to go to college. She will be attending the University of Houston, majoring in biology this fall. She will then pursue a Bachelor's of Science in Dental Hygiene. Oh boy, time for Silas. Silas moved to Skagway when we were in fourth grade. I was assigned to show him and his sister around the classroom. Fourth and fifth grades were combined at the time. I thought Silas was a girl's name, and I saw a boy and a girl walk through the door. So the first thing that came to my mind was that the girl was Silas and the boy was Eliza. Oh, and also I was bald after a lice outbreak and wearing a polka dot pink dress. I ended up showing them around and eventually learned their names. Silas plans on staying in Skagway for the summer, working for the city. In the fall, Silas will be going to play basketball overseas. Well, on to me. I have lived in Skagway for my entire life. I plan on moving to Sitka to work for the summer and take part-time classes through the UAS campus there in the fall. I will definitely be back to visit Skagway, but I am so excited to start this new chapter of my life. And to the grandparents, parents, mentors, siblings, cousins, pets, friends, and especially our class advisor, my mother, Heather Rodig, thank you so much for supporting all of us and helping us through the tough times and laughing with us at the best times. We are so grateful for this community and all of the love we've received all these years. Thank you, Skagway.
And I'd also like to extend that thanks to all the other teachers who have also helped us get to where we are now. Thank you for always looking out for us. Although the people involved in our academic careers thus far have been incredibly helpful, we of course can't forget the people that have been here for us since before we were even born, our parents and family. Thank you for always pushing us to do our best and teaching us some of the most important lessons in life. We can't express our gratitude and appreciation enough. Lastly, we'd like to extend our thanks to this community and our friends as a whole. Over the years, we have been incredibly supported by you all, and we can't express our thanks enough for not only being here for us throughout the years, but also now meeting us at the finish line and celebrating this incredible moment with us. This community is home, and we could not be more proud to be Skagwegians. And I personally would like to give one last thanks to my other family, my classmates. Thank you, Silas, Peyton, Ash, Jackson, and Michaela, for just being here at the right time and the right place. I love you guys.